KKHT wants you to meet the classiest guys in real estate.
This is Tim O'Neill, the icon of insurance.
I'm Chris Kelso, the Meister of Mortgage.
And I am Rob Cook, the Godfather of Real Estate. And together we are
the Real Estate Rat Pack.
Much like us, real estate in the greater Houston area is hot.
So whether you're buying, selling, owning, or insuring real estate in the greater Houston area,
you need to check us out as we are the preeminent source for everything you need to know.
And now, they're here to take your calls and answer your questions live. Call now, 1-800-808-5548. The Real Estate Rat Pack.
Good morning, Houston.
And surrounding areas.
And the surrounding Houston area. That
I don't want to forget about it. You know, we have a lot of good friends out there, out in the Woodlands and Sugarland and Pearland. So
we have them everywhere,
we
by
got
the
them
way.
Everywhere. So.
You know what else we have everywhere? We have everywhere throughout the greater Houston area a lot of mamas.
Oh, Mother's Day.
And Mother's Day is coming up tomorrow, by the way. So the Rat Pack wants to give a very big, warm embrace and thank all the mothers out there who are...
Who put up with our stuff for all those
years. Who put up with
our
stuff for a long time, exactly. But let me tell you, being a mom is hard, hard work.
Never having been one, but it looked hard.
Yes.
I would have set me out on the side of the road a long time ago.
From my wife all the way down to any woman that I know who is a mother has proven it to me. It is hard work, trust me. But... You know, we have a little man in the studio right here who wants to say something to his mom. What do you want to say?
Happy Mother's Day, Mommy.
There he goes.
That's Big Dog. Beautiful.
Yeah, the Big Dog's in the studio. House. He wanted to say Happy Mother's Day, Mommy. And to all the other mothers out there, we want to wish a very, very warm Real Estate Rat Pack Happy Mother's Day.
I hope you have something special planned for Regina.
The kids do. I am supporting that endeavor.
Yes, okay.
Yes.
Good.
But technically they do.
So I want to thank everybody who showed up on the bus yesterday.
We had
a good time. We went to the Golden Nugget in Lake Charles.
That is correct.
Once again, and everyone had a good time. I don't think anyone walked away with any money.
No. Actually, no. I think several people did walk away with some money.
Well, I did because guess what?
Yes.
I don't gamble.
You don't gamble.
So I always break even.
And it was a beautiful day at the pool, by the way.
It was a beautiful day.
Gorgeous day at the pool. So
we appreciate everybody who participated.
Yep.
So we got an interesting show today. We've never had a roofer come on.
That is true. Absolutely.
And of course, we have a returning. She's officially a two-timer.
Yes.
Monica Vaca.
She's a two-timer.
So, I know Monica's got to get to an appointment today, so I think we ought to probably start off. Of course,
I would absolutely agree.
So we can let her go.
That way she can start and she can finish. She can have a good time and she can go out there and do something that we all like to do, which is sell real estate. Isn't that correct?
Absolutely.
You know, we got a mic right there for you.
Yeah.
All right, guys.
Yeah. Well, Mike,
I got a new nickname this morning. Two-timer. Ooh,
I don't know
if that's a good thing or a bad thing.
I was trying to remember. You were on our premier year, I think.
Yes, absolutely.
Tell us a little bit about you, where you are, and then we're going to talk about the market and how your business has been looking. Because you said it's been going up, and we love hearing that stuff.
No, absolutely. Well, I'm about 29 years into real estate. I am the broker owner of Century 21, the real estate group, on Memorial, and specialized very many years with investors and foreclosures, and you know, so I'm still doing the same thing, and we have a team of about 20 agents, but I'm also a very active sales professional within the firm.
So you're still very active in that market yourself. So you're not you're not just herding cats. You're also selling real estate.
That is correct.
So anyway, well, talk a little bit about the market because I know your focus isn't just Memorial. You kind of get
we go all over. Well, the market compared to let's say last year is tremendously picked up. I think that we're seeing our inventory numbers come up quite a bit month by month and. March was a rather slow month, but April cleaned up very quickly.
Yeah, because you know I'm hearing mixed reviews out there because I've had some people say they've slowed, and we've seen that people that are dealing in the higher end, that you know 500, 700, they're seeing their market slow down, in like the Woodlands and Katy and those type of areas.
Well, I can tell you that definitely the upper end, like you said, the 500 and over, are taking quite a bit. Depending on what subdivisions, what communities you work. There, but in overall, anything over 500, 700 is taking quite a bit. I mean, we're talking about 300 days on the market. So it's that market has slowed down. And one of the markets that I don't think has ever slowed down, regardless of what we have had, you know, what recession we've had or not, has been the first-time homebuyers market. The first-time homebuyer market, it's is growing and it's steady.
Well, Chris, I would agree with you right there.
You know, rates are still at an all-time low, right, Chris?
You know, rates right now are back to an all-time low. I did not think, you know, I thought at the beginning of the year when they got low again, I was like, okay, it's, but now they are back to where we have not seen them in a long time. And it's sort of that, it's sort of that, how low can you go? It's one of those perfect storms, I think. I mean, we have, you know, interest rates, which are extremely low. We still have a lot of good inventory out there. You know, as you were mentioning, Monica, there's some areas, you know, that we're even seeing a pickup right now. You know, that market that had lagged a little bit, you know, in the let's say 750 plus, we're starting to see a lot of those buyers come back in for the summer, which is pretty neat. But you're right, the first-time home buyer, though, is still extremely strong out there.
Oh, definitely. And, you know, the great thing about the first-time home buyer is that the price range has increased tremendously. You know, with an average price range in Houston of about $272,000, that's fantastic. So, and what I'm seeing also, which I had not seen in the past few years, is that the buyers at this point in time, the first-time home buyers in the 200, 300, which are still first-time home buyers, the age of these buyers is phenomenal. They're 27, 30, 31 right. years old, 30 yep. years old, 35 years old, and they're
responsible.
They're responsible. I just love to work with that. I mean, you know, if you're out there and you're just graduated college, or if you're, you know, just out of your first year and at work or whatever it is, and if you fall into that price range, you can buy, because I see so many of these millennials renting for $2,000, $3,000 a month. It's crazy.
I know, and you're absolutely right. You know, one of the things they're coming into the market. They're very well qualified. They're buying an average home, which is not the average starter home that
Correct.
We used to see 10 years ago. You know, the average starter home they're coming into is 225, 250 range. But I think they've got that mature. You know, one of the things that we've seen, you know, we had Robert Hahn on, we talked about this, is we've seen that maturity. Individuals, it used to be, you know, you get out, 21, you're married, 24, you have kids, 25, and now what you're seeing, that's all sort of expanded. Now the average person's getting married later in life. They're buying a home a little bit, when I say later, in their later 20s, early 30s, but it's caused them to have that maturity. And it's a lot of fun to see that, and it's very interesting to go through that process.
I'm always curious with people who are working with first-time homebuyers, what do they look for? What's their motivator, do you think, typically? Are they looking for lifestyle? Are they looking for location?
You know, a lot of them are looking for location more than lifestyle. I think location has always been, you know, that's an old adage in real estate.
Yeah, location.
But I would think it's a little bit of both. Some do look for lifestyle. I see that the younger professional nowadays has a very good head on their shoulders, and they are more focused on the numbers of what they can afford. But many of them don't know what they can afford yet. So that's when, you know, a person like you, Chris, comes in to work together with a real estate professional, in which we can guide them. And it's true. It used to be, you know, I got married at 18. My daughter, instead, she just got married last October, and she's 29. So, and
yes,
she's building her house. They're, you know, buying their house. So their structure is a little different.
I'm doing the math over here. Okay.
Yeah. I know. No, I'm still 20. I'm
still
12,
29.
I'm still 40.
I was never good at math.
I started young, I said.
And of course, it doesn't matter where in the greater Houston area the home is or where you buy your home. Everyone still wants the kids to go to Katy schools, right?
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
So it's like far, far north Katy and far west Katy. I've got to find an address somehow to get to Katy school.
You know, I found, well, Katy and Cypress are fabulous school districts, and the Woodlands, of course. But, you know, a lot of people are also looking in the Spring Branch area. Mm-hmm. Spring Branch is an older neighborhood that it is just,
starting
you know,
those teardowns.
Those teardowns, I'm telling you, those teardowns are unbelievable. And you know what? These people would, especially young professionals, don't mind going in and buying a small house, you know, that is a fixer-upper and being in that school district. So it's about priorities.
Until
really.
They find out what a fixer-upper really looks
well.
Like.
Well, you know, what's amazing
fixer-upper myself.
Yeah, I mean, Monica's office is located right there in the heart of Memorial. I mean, so if you look at it, she has all of West Memorial. She has all Memorial proper. She's literally, you know, less
location.
Than a mile away from Spring Branch over there with all that redevelopment. I mean, And we see it because we talked about this all the time. Is all, you know, if you grab from your office and you look at a 10-mile radius right there, it's a tremendous investment opportunity. Still.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. You know, and investors, I have had so many investors and international buyers this last this last year, it's unbelievable. And there's still great deals out there. I mean, yeah. I have a lot of investors that are still buying.
Where are your investors coming from?
Latin America.
Latin America.
Latin America. Yep. All of Latin America.
That's awesome.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So it's, well, the one thing I was reading about millennials and things like that, they actually are a little more level-headed than some of us boomers, and that they aren't necessarily going for the biggest or something like that. They're actually, they're putting their budgeting to make sure the house fits their, you know, they want to do other things rather than, because in our generation, they said, buy as much house as you can get.
As long as there's a place for their Xbox, they're fine.
But they're not going for the big houses and stuff like that. They're actually going for something a little more compact because they can be a little closer in, smaller.
You know, I truly agree with that. Perfect example, and I keep referring to my daughter because I'm just so proud of her and her husband. They're at this age, you know, 29, between 20, you know, 29 and 35, and they bought below what their approval was, and you know, they look at the, you know, distance from work, the location was important, school district was important, all these things. So I see the same trend with that age group. So I think it's fantastic, and they're wonderful to work with. They're absolutely wonderful to work with.
Right, very educated buyer. You know, and the other thing that's happened is the advent of where we stand nowadays, I mean, the HAR app, I look at that, how educated they can get now and walk through the process and really have, you know, you have a very good millennial educated buyer who's very in tune with what they can afford, who want to buy, as you mentioned, below their budget, but then also they don't know how to use technology. You know, whether it be e-docs, whether it be, I mean, all those type of things that make the transaction extremely easy.
That's why agents better be really sharp, because they're going to find out their buyers and sellers are going to be a lot more informed than they are. So they need to stay in that leading edge of that information.
You took the words right out of my mouth. Let me tell you, that is one thing nowadays. You know, technology is a wonderful thing, but it can be a taboo as well in for certain people. Yes, as an agent, you really have to be up to date and prepared. And you have to be bold about, you know, technology and do that. One of the reasons I love to work with this generation is that I don't have to go in, you know, meet them for a signature. It's like everything is DocuSign, done.
And they want everything right now.
Exactly.
And they expect it. Because, you know, it used to be, I mean, we first started getting in the internet. I remember that we were doing that migration over to the internet in 97 with HAR. And the expectation at that time was you return an email within 48 hours.
Right.
Now it's probably more like 48 seconds.
Right.
I mean, they move on quickly if they don't get a response. And you know what? Boomers have become the same way. You know, like, really? You know?
Pretty much moved on from email.
It's been 30 seconds.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Well, you know, and I think you're right, though. I mean, everyone's, we're in the now moment right now. It's what can you do right now to take care? I mean, if you can't, individuals move on, unfortunately. But, you know, there's a way to utilize technology. And I talk about this all the time. In fact, we have a class about this, which is, creating a relationship or a physical touch out of that digital footprint, right?
It's just a conduit for a good relationship.
That is correct. And so I still think nothing's ever going to take away the ability to create a good relationship. And technology should be something that enhances the process, doesn't take away from that relationship still. And I think that's one of the things, and that's the key to technology still today, is
absolutely
educating individuals how to maintain, you know, a relationship. Because anyone who's doing transactions is not what we want to do. We're creating relationships. That is
right.
Correct.
That's when, you know, you and I, and our a man here, Tim, we're all that same way.
Right.
You know, it's all about the relationships, and we're different age groups and stuff like that. So nothing's going to replace that touch, which is why when people talk about being disintermediated by technology, I don't think that's going to happen ever.
A personal phone call is always appreciated.
It's
the best relationship builder.
The internet's just a big Rolodex if you think about it.
Right.
There you go.
Yeah. Good way to put it. You know, we're coming up against a break here right now. So how can we get a hold of you, Monica?
Super easy. 281-831-4935.
And she still answers her phones.
And I sure do. And one more time.
281-831-4935.
If they just want to go to a website, where would they go?
Century 21. Best way to get
hold of
you.
I told you I wouldn't ask any hard questions.
Yeah, that was a hard one. See, the best way is 281-831-4935.
That is awesome. Well, that is the great Monica Vodka. She is with Century 21 right there in Memorial. We have to take a break, but stay tuned. We'll be right back. Oh, baby, no, baby. You got me all wrong, baby. My baby's already got all of my love. So no.
Are you looking to finance a new home or refinance your existing home? Look no further. Call Chris Kelso at Willow Bend Mortgage. Willow Bend Mortgage is a mortgage banker in the greater Houston area. In business since 1993, Willow Bend Mortgage offers a great array of products from FHA, VA, and USDA loans to conventional and jumbo loans, all with great rates and incredible service from Chris and his staff. Call Chris Kelso at Willow Bend Mortgage today, 713-256-9138, or online at chriskelso.com. Again, that's 713-256-9138, or online at chriskelso.com. Available 24 hours a day. Great rates, exceptional service. That's Willow Bend Mortgage.
Down Under Pools can help make your backyard a focal point for luxury outdoor living. Imagine coming home from a hard day's work and enjoying the evening in a spa-like environment with pool, water features, and lighting integrated seamlessly into your home and landscaping design. Down Under's design team has a seasoned eye for color, scale, proportion, and detail. Even more important is Down Under's commitment to the highest quality construction practices to achieve the highest standards of hydraulic and structural integrity. Down Under is one of the most creative and trusted pool and landscape builders in Houston because of their award-winning design and construction and an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau. Visit downunderpools.com to see examples of what could be in your backyard. That's downundapools.com. Down Under, pools for the mind, body, and soul. Berkshire Hathaway Home Services Anderson Properties, the fastest growing real estate company in Houston. Over 400 trained professional realtors here to serve your needs in 21 locations in Houston and across the state. Whether you're buying, selling, or leasing, Berkshire Hathaway Home Services Anderson Properties is the smart choice. Check us out at andersonprops.com today. Find out why so many choose Berkshire Hathaway Home Services Anderson Properties for all of their real estate needs. You know us, we know real estate.
What you wanna do, baby? Where you wanna go? I'll take you to the moon, baby. I'll take you to the floor. I treat you like a real lady, no matter where you go. Just give me some time, baby, 'cause you know, even when we're apart, I know my heart is still.
And we're back.
Hey, welcome. What now?
We are back, guys.
Yeah, we are back.
I was too busy. I was too busy dancing in the studio.
I know you're
right
dancing
there.
Till you put your headsets on.
Real estate rat pack. Where
are we? Well, you know, we have some callers actually right now.
You know,
we need
to
get to.
We're gonna have to prioritize here. And as much as we, you know, loved Diane and Christy, Randall's out there with the YPN group, rebuilding a house.
That is true. He is out there right there, but he hasn't called in yet. So
oh,
as
he has
soon
not.
As he calls in. Then we will prioritize him.
Okay. Well, I understood. You're looking at the board. I can't see the board.
Yeah, no, I can see it right there. No, let's go ahead and go to Diane.
Okay.
Diane Moore. She is on, called in. Diane, how you doing?
Hello.
I'm good. How are you doing?
Doing great. You got a beautiful day today. Go out and sell some real estate.
It is very pretty. Definitely a perfect day to go showing properties and for people to buy them. So, yes, sir.
So I understand that you have something that you wanted to talk with us about as far as an announcement. Is that what Chris was over there making some sort of hand signals and things like that?
Yes, sir. I was just wanting to give a quick shout out to our local real estate industry, you know, agents, title company, et cetera, inspectors. United Real Estate is holding a party, a social, a time to have fun, let our hair down for a minute. This coming Tuesday, May 10th, from 4:30 to 7.
Oh.
And everybody is invited, so we'd love to see as many people there as we could.
Well, you know, I would love to be there, but I'll be have already landed in Washington, D.C. You know, we have our Hill visits this next
Absolutely.
Week.
Absolutely.
And my man Tim here is going to be going up there, too, on Monday.
Which means I'm the one being volunteered. I can see it right
yeah,
now.
Yeah,
Well, we always do whatever we can for our Rat Pack family to support
They're
them.
They're both looking at me.
Yeah. So, yeah. No pressure. Well, you know, it's important that we do this every year. And, Dan, I know you've been involved. We go up there. We talk to our congressmen and senators about, you know, property rights issues and things like that. You know,
absolutely.
They're still trying to take away the MID, mortgage interest deduction. They're still trying to take away some things from property owners, and we want to go up there and fight and make sure we maintain that stuff.
And it's a very important fight. I agree.
And so I guess to do a shout out to Gina Devers, who I think is one of your newest members of your team.
She is.
Congratulations.
Did we have a nice time at our margarita trolley tour, or did we not?
We did.
That was a great afternoon. So where is the big wingding on Tuesday night?
Yes, sir. It's at our office, which is located at 3131 Briar Park Drive. Of course, it's in Houston, 77042 for anybody's navigation. But it's basically just inside the Beltway and just south of Westheimer.
Easy to find. Been there. Nice office.
Yes, sir.
Featuring Chris
Thank
Kelso.
You.
Well, Feature, I will definitely be there.
Well, you have to be
the
there
Rat
now.
Back. Absolutely. I've got no choice now, do I?
So
I would love to.
So go ahead one more time, Diane. Give us the address and the time and the date.
You got it. That's going to be at the United Real Estate Houston office, which is located at 3131 Briar Park Drive, Suite 125. But basically, when you walk in the doors, it's the first door on the right, Houston 77042, basically inside the Beltway and just south of Westheimer. And it's next Tuesday, May 10th, from 4:30 to 7.
Nice.
That is awesome.
So
well, Diane, we always appreciate you calling in. Thank you very much. I will see you on Tuesday, and hopefully we'll round up a whole bunch of other ones that we'll see you with as well.
Yeah, Monica's over here jotting down the
awesome.
Address.
Yes.
We're going to make sure Monica shows up.
This is going to be a great party.
Yep, we're going to make sure she's there as well for you.
Wonderful. Well, thanks so much. Look forward to seeing everybody there.
Likewise,
Diane.
Thank
day.
You.
Y'all too.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
So we have somebody else.
And we have, absolutely. Okay. We have Christy, who is also calling in. Christy, how you doing?
I'm doing well, gentlemen. How are you? Hi, Chris.
Hey, how are you doing?
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Glad to hear your voices. I am out here at the Blanton Davis Ovarian Cancer Research Sprint for Life, and just feeling vibrant and full of life. And so I thought, since I was up at the crack of dawn, I'd give you guys a call.
I got a lot of energy and no way to spend it, right?
She's like, I know three guys that are definitely awake at this
yes.
hour.
I do. Yeah. Usually I might be catching my Z's, but just feeling excited out here at the medical center and just seeing all the people. And I talked to a 17-year cancer survivor, and she was third place in her age group. And I ran the whole race, street.
Yay.
I never stopped. So that was all my goal. And
congratulations
and I'm still
on that.
Alive.
Nice.
That is awesome. You know, and then that's, you know, one of the things we talk about all the time, the Rat Pack is very much into assisting and doing things such as, you know, walks and runs. And
I thought you were going to say physical fitness there. Come on.
Come
on.
There is no fireball here.
Yeah, we're into supporting it, by the way.
But license here.
Yeah, and that's exactly what made me. You hear the ambulances in the background here, being in the medical center. So, you know, just a couple things. I was thinking along the lines, I knew that you guys would, you guys are always out in the community and supporting things like this. And so I wanted to share this with you and just kind of touch on our medical center and what an amazing thing it is down here supporting our Houston community. And you know, it's a huge part of bringing people into the Houston area from a real estate standpoint. And, you know, also as, you know, we've seen a little bit of the downturn in the oil area. We got to remember that we've got this amazing thing down here, and there's construction going on. And, you know, I know that it helped the medical center and Texas Children's helped save my nephew. Unfortunately, my mom didn't survive, but they tried their best, and she died of secondary ovarian cancer. And so this is near and dear to my heart out here. And, of course, Houston and community, you guys. And, you know, also getting out there and trying something that you haven't done in a while and just making a goal and doing that and you know, set your goals and just give it a try. You may make a 41 minute 3 mile run, but you made it, right?
Yeah,
that is true.
Exactly.
In Tim's case, it might be 3 hours, but
yeah, you know, there's still some coming in. Tim would be at the very end. He's back there doing fireballs.
In the Barca Lounger edition.
But you know, you bring up a great point, though, Christine. I think it's very neat to know, you know, that you know, healthcare is our number one employer right now in Houston, in general, when it comes to the amount of employees. Our healthcare center, the Texas Medical Center, brings in more foreign nationals than any other reason, including oil and gas here, because of that service. And I can tell you, I've been down there firsthand. My daughter, obviously, was in Texas Children's Hospital when she was born and went through multiple heart surgeries there with Dr. Frazier. Big shout out to Dr. Frazier at Texas Children's. But we have some of the leading science and technologies and methodologies going on at the Texas Medical Center that you would not believe. It's absolutely tremendous. And you know, cancer is an example of something that's you know, proliferating throughout our market and our friends and our family and our homes. And we have the MD Anderson Medical Center down there, which is absolutely tremendous things, and not only saving a lot of people, but also trying to find different cures and developments for different things right there. So,
exactly along those lines. And I want to share two things out here that, you know, and just like almost tears were flowing. They had the survivors stand on the stage, and I mean, like almost broke the stage. And I'll maybe post a picture out there here a little later. And also, you know, there's education here as well, and there's genetic testing that you can do, and there's genetic counseling that you can do. And I come to find out maybe or maybe not your insurance can pay for it. So if you have those histories, you know, being proactive, and that's part of, you know, living this life to your fullest and, you know, not only giving back, but also learning at events like this. And it was just really amazing to see. And matter of fact, the gal that was talking on the stage is the doctor who started Sprint for Life. And it was just very inspiring and to know that this is going on right here in Houston and lives are being saved and touched. And I talked to a 17-year survivor, you know, just amazing, just amazing.
Well, we really appreciate you calling in. For all those listeners who don't know, that is the great Christy Stratton. She is
trying to teach us etiquette.
She is absolutely. She's trying to educate us on the ability to be more etiquette, I guess, or teach
well,
us etiquette.
That's,
period.
Rat pack, you know, survivor herself. It's the new face of etiquette is kind of what I'm calling it, is which is the back to the basics. But it's also being involved in your community. It's supporting people. It's giving more than you expect to get. You know, it's just giving, you know, and just being involved in your community. And that's really, a lot of people think etiquette is this snobbish, pretentious thing, and it's not. It's, you know, you put on your running gear, it's being involved, you put on your running gear, you get out here, you support the community, and you guys are leading the way.
Yeah. Well, I like to go boating every once in a while. And
oh, man, don't even.
we'll just have a moment of silence.
Respect for that dead subject.
We'll take off to the raceway. Well, thanks, guys, for talking with me this morning. I will see you guys very soon.
Yes.
And thanks a bunch.
Are you going to Washington, D.C.? Oh, by the way?
I am not.
Oh, man. I'm not going either then.
come on now. I will actually.
Tim's like, that's it. I'm out.
I know you're going to send a bill off here, but I'll actually be at the Barbara Cochran Champion School of Real Estate keynote.
Oh, I will see you as well.
Yeah, I'll be greeting, so I'll see you. So that's Wednesday morning. So I decided to hang here and not do the DC thing. Right.
Chris will be our rat rep.
I will be the rat rep right there.
I've
got a
rat
VIP
rep.
Ticket. Yes.
Woohoo! And, look at you.
Yes, very.
I got a greeter ticket. No, I'm kidding. I got a VIP ticket. I teach for the school. So.
Courtesy of Natalie, who I really appreciate that, by the way. So.
Well.
Yep, I'll see you there.
Yeah, absolutely. Looking forward to it. It's going to be a great thing.
Well, good deal. Well. We appreciate you calling in. Have a great day, and I'll see you later on this week.
Go take another
right.
lap.
Hi to everyone. Yeah. Okay. Love you guys.
Likewise.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye. So that was a great call-in.
That was a great call-in.
You know, you'll talk about when people are getting involved. I've always gotten back a lot more than I ever put in.
Yeah.
It doesn't seem to fail that you're always going to get more back.
You always will. And, you know, and we talk about here at the Rat Pack, we do a lot of different things for the Sunshine Kids. We do things for DePelchin Children's Center. You know, I personally do things outside of that as well.
And Chris
is
a great elf.
Yeah, exactly.
And Chris makes a great elf.
Exactly.
We have photos.
Exactly. And Monica and I, that is correct, we do different things during different holiday seasons. And during the Christmas time, I'll dress up as an elf, and it's really good.
Hark, I hear music in the background.
You do.
That means we're coming up against a break.
That means we have a break coming up.
We got Victor Marik coming up next. He's going to tell us all about roofs.
You know what? But until then, stay tuned. We'll be right back. We're taking it down. 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 We're taking it down.
Are you looking to finance a new home or refinance your existing home? Look no further. Call Chris Kelso at Willow Bend Mortgage. Willow Bend Mortgage is a mortgage banker in the greater Houston area. In business since 1993, Willow Bend Mortgage offers a great array of products from FHA, VA, and USDA loans to conventional and jumbo loans, all with great rates and incredible service from Chris and his staff. Call Chris Kelso at Willow Bend Mortgage today, 713-256-9138, or online at chriskelso.com. Again, that's 713-256-9138, or online at chriskelso.com. Available 24 hours a day. Great rates, exceptional service. That's Willow Bend Mortgage.
Berkshire Hathaway Home Services Anderson Properties, the fastest growing real estate company in Houston. Over 400 trained professional realtors here to serve your needs in 21 locations in Houston and across the state. Whether you're buying, selling, or leasing, Berkshire Hathaway Home Services Anderson Properties is the smart choice. Check us out at AndersonProps.com today. Find out why so many choose Berkshire Hathaway Home Services Anderson Properties for all of their real estate needs. You know us, we know real estate. Protect your number one valued asset, your home. Want to know who home builders, commercial property, and real estate professionals call when they have a foundation issue? Perma Pier Foundation Repair of Texas. You can access the same professional grade services the pros choose, all backed by a lifetime transferable warranty and over 15,000 successfully completed projects. Visit permapier.com. That's permapier.com to schedule your free evaluation today.
Back.
The classic is much guys better this time. In real estate.
Absolutely. Absolutely right there. You know, we were talking between the break about, you know, giving back to society, giving back to the community, you know, everything that is going on out there. You know, and Monica and I were talking about, most people didn't realize about what actually went on in the earthquake in Ecuador, which has really devastated Ecuador and city and people, et cetera. And so Monica's really involved actually with working and getting assistance and doing some charity work. Talk a little bit about that.
Well, certainly, and thank you very much for giving me this little airtime to say this. I know most of you like chocolate and you like roses, and you know Ecuador is a tiny country in South America, but probably we're one of the richest countries in the world in which we export cacao and the you know the beautiful flowers, beautiful roses all over the world. And we had a 7.8 on the Richter scale earthquake in the coast of on the Pacific coast of Ecuador, which rattled the city of Guayaquil, Manta, and even the people in the capital felt it. Yes, even the people in the capital felt it. And my parents are originally Ecuadorian, and we're, you know, that's our country of origin. And so about, I want to say the last count was about 600 dead, about 1,500 missing, about 6,000 injured. But the most incredible thing is that a whole city has been destroyed. People have no homes. They are homeless. They have absolutely, they're living under the sun and the, you know, and under the elements. And we are in desperate need of dry food, mostly tents. We're in desperate need of tents. We have plenty of water. But it's, you know, again, a little extra will definitely help. My sister and I, Nina Vaca, who she's been extremely involved with the United States Hispanic Chamber of Commerce. We have, in partnership with the United States Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, we have developed a fund so that people can contribute and we can raise some money for the.
So tell them where they can go.
So they can go to www.gofundme.com. /2EZJPYH8. So it's www.gofundme.com. It's easier when I text this.
Okay.
/2EZJPYH8. But our office is a drop-off location for donations. So if anybody would like to contribute a tent, or if you want to come in and, you know, or give me a shout at 281-831-4935. I will text you this link so that you can contribute. My office is at 1313 Memorial Drive. The Consulate of Ecuador is working out of our office at this time and taking donations as well. So anything that we can help to we can do to help our, you know, our brothers and sisters in Ecuador will be great.
So money always helps. So that's usually the easiest, because everything else weighs and you have to ship it and things like that. And
you know, we've gotten a lot of contribution. For example, United Airlines is giving us cargo space, unlimited cargo space. So we, any contributions we get, we immediately send it over there. And we've got the Rotary Club from Guayaquil, from Ecuador, from all the Rotary Clubs are helping tremendously. Even the Rotary Club here in Houston is taking applications for people that want to go and help. Because one of the other things that we need tremendously is human hands to help.
Well, again, it's not really making the news. It made the news back when it happened, which was what you
right.
said, April 16th.
April 16th.
And here we are into May 7th. And I'm not seeing it on the news.
No,
at all.
It's terrible. It's terrible. It really is.
Thanks for making us aware of that.
Well, thank you. Thank you for allowing me to talk about this today.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Anytime. You know, that's what we're about. And speaking of putting roofs on people, by the way, in Ecuador, we're going to circle back around here to speak about roofing here in Houston.
And so we have Victor Marik, who is with Hudson Bay Roofing. You're a long way from Hudson Bay.
Well, I've been to Canada a few times, and that's why I named the company after a part of Canada.
Yeah, it's a beautiful part of the world. Yeah. So talk a little bit about, you know, how you started, the genesis of Hudson Bay, when you started, and where you are now.
I got into construction back in June of 1976, and I'll never forget the first job I had was a roofing job, and it was close to Braeswood and Hillcroft, and I made the grand total of $1,500. And I was really making money back then.
And well, that's now, 1976 dollars. That is a lot of money back in 1976.
It was real good. And I'll never forget getting into construction, and I'm still in it. I also give classes on roofing to real estate agents. The construction company's been good to us. I do all different types of roofs, from composition. I'll tell you a little story. Back in 1979, here in Houston, we had a fire at an apartment complex on Sage, close to Briar Forest. And the apartment complex burned to the ground. And Cedar Shake Shingles. And after that, the Cedar Shakes were outlawed, basically outlawed. I mean, you still can have Cedar Shakes put on, but they have to be treated. But getting back to Hudson Bay, I've been in it a long time. My family's involved with it. We do all different types of roofs.
Well, I mean, you do commercial as well? Or?
Oh, yeah, we do commercial and residential, yes.
You do the built-up, load-master roofs, things like that?
Yes.
Like that. And, you know, a lot of times, every time we have a storm, you probably get a lot of calls.
Well, yeah.
As does our boy Tim. I'm sure he gets a lot
of
calls.
But, you know, the bad thing about that is, in the great state of Texas, you do not have to be licensed to be a roofing contractor. So what happens, people come in from all over, and they sell jobs, they do jobs, they warranty the jobs, but they're not there after there's a problem. The thing about Hudson Bay is a company that's been around a long time, but the people that run the company are not the important people of the company. It's the person who actually do the jobs, the subcontractors.
Yeah, and that's hard work too. But it's one of the things we've talked about Texas. The good thing about Texas is sometimes the not so good thing about Texas, we don't have licensing for a lot of trades. And so we actually have done some things with our contracts, and Monica's aware of this, that, you know, part of the things when doing repairs, you have to have people who are commercially engaged in doing it on a consistent basis. Cause you know, it doesn't, if you have a nice pickup truck, you can be a roofer, right?
You know,
but like you say, are they going to be there tomorrow if something has to be looked at or adjusted or anything of that nature?
But you know, as a real estate professional, I really appreciate Victor, because I've had him in my office and give that class to our realtors and to realtors from other firms that come in and take this class that we host at the office. And you have to have that knowledge. You have to be able to you know, at least guide your customers. You're not in any shape, way, or form trying to say that you're an expert in roofing, But as a real estate profession, you have to have some knowledge of the different types of roof, or, you know, to be able to point out maybe, hey, this might be a potential problem for my buyer or for my seller. So it is definitely important that we educate ourselves.
There's a lot of difference on the roof and things like that. I always tell people if they want to ask for a roof to be replaced as a part of the consideration of purchasing a home, there's a lot of different kind of roofs out there, a lot of different qualities and things.
Well, you know, we kind of dated ourselves when we said, oh, the cedar shingles.
Yeah.
Remember cedar that when shingles. I first started in real estate?
I remember that was Woodway. Burnt. I remember that was a horrible fire. Roof to roof.
The thing about, you know, like we do not have to be licensed, but the good thing about the municipalities that we have, you know, like West U, Bel Air, Sugarland, you have to have insurance to get a permit. So, in other words, a roof are not supposed to be installed without a permit. Believe it or not, even in the city of Houston, you're supposed to have a permit.
Well, do they always pull those permits?
Not in the city of Houston, but they don't have I don't think the city has the manpower to go around checking. Yeah, to regulate that. But the other cities do.
So what are things that consumers should know about roof or replacing a roof, or what to look for if it needs replacing?
Well, one thing you look for are the people that are going to do the job. The BBB is important in our occupations that we do. But another thing that's important, the warranties are very important nowadays. All the manufacturers are different than 5 years ago. The warranties now you can get that the manufacturer is responsible for labor and material on the product, like for 20 years. So in other words, if anything goes wrong with that roofing material, they'll pay for the labor and material to replace it.
That is different, because usually they used to prorate the shingles only.
That's correct. It's changed a lot. And there are different types of, so many different types of roofs. There's metal, there's concrete, composition, the wood. And besides the composition or the actual shingles that you see, the more important product is the underlayment that is underneath the product that is installed. For example, your concrete roofs. The concrete roofs look good, but actually, if you get up on the roof, you can see cracks, missing tiles, but it is the underlayment that keeps the water out of the house.
Exactly, and of course, and something when you have tile and concrete and things like that, you have to have a pretty beefy substructure.
Yes.
And I remember there was a builder back in the 70s and 80s, he was building a lot of tile roofs, but he wasn't properly supporting it. And it's a tremendous difference in weight. Because what is the square of composition weight typically?
Around 200, 240 pounds. And your concrete can weigh up to 950 to 1,000 pounds. So if you put 1,000 pounds on a regular house that has a 30-year shingle, well, you might as well call somebody to come get you out of that house. Yeah. They're going to cave in on you.
You seem very much... There's a relatively new product out there, the rubberized impact-resistant shingles, which do qualify for insurance discounts in some cases, but they don't seem to be catching on very much. And obviously the labor is the same. I'm wondering if the price spread on those versus traditional fiberglass, is it coming together?
It's quite a bit difference in price, you know. But the insurance companies do give a rebate and stuff, a discount on your.
Are you seeing very many people go opt for the impact resistant?
No, it's not as popular. But we don't get the hail like parts of Texas, like Dallas, Fort Worth do.
Yeah,
we've had hail several times here in our area, but pea size it's not like a.
Yeah, it's a shame because if people don't embrace them, they won't make them anymore. So it's a good idea.
Correct.
It's a good project. I mean, good product. But other thing, reminiscing about roofing, we probably have seen the last of the metric shingles are probably gone out there. I remember when I was a claims adjuster, you get up there and you'd be ready to go, and then wait a minute, this is a metric shingle, and at that time they didn't make them then.
Mm-hmm.
And so when you had partial damage on a roof that was covered with metric shingles.
But you know what?
Yeah, Maestro's over here saying, we're up against a break.
We absolutely are up against a break, and the music is running. We're going to continue this conversation a little bit more, though. Stay tuned. We'll be right back. I love it. Oh, I can feel my
face when I'm with you. I love it. Does it matter who does your real estate inspections? You bet it does. You want someone knowledgeable and experienced, someone you can rely on and trust. You want A.B. Bowles Home Inspections. Owned by Ashley Bowles, A.B. Bowles Home Inspections makes client satisfaction a priority. You'll get detailed, easy-to-read reports. Plus, they'll take the time to explain the report to you before and after the inspection. If you're investing in real estate for your family or as a business, call A.B. Bowles Home Inspections at 832-306-3723. That's 832-306-3723.
Down Under Pools can help make your backyard a focal point for luxury outdoor living. Imagine coming home from a hard day's work and enjoying the evening in a spa-like environment with pool, water features, and lighting integrated seamlessly into your home and landscaping design. Down Under's design team has a seasoned eye for color, scale, proportion, and detail. Even more important is Down Under's commitment to the highest quality construction practices to achieve the highest standards of hydraulic and structural integrity. Down Under is one of the most creative and trusted pool and landscape builders in Houston because of their award-winning design and construction and an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau. Visit downunderpools.com to see examples of what could be in your backyard. That's downundapools.com. Down Under. Pools for the mind, body, and soul.
Protect your number one valued asset, your home. Want to know who home builders, commercial property, and real estate professionals call when they have a foundation issue? Perma Peer Foundation Repair of Texas. You can access the same professional-grade services the pros choose, all backed by a lifetime transferable warranty and over 15,000 successfully completed projects. Visit permapeer.com. That's permapeer.com to schedule your free evaluation today.
You know, so sorry to be here in the studio. I really meant to be out there with that 3 mile run this morning.
You know, I know.
My
I
partners
know.
Would not give me the morning off, so here I am.
And you know,
we'll give you next week off.
That song, that intro right there, reminds me of prom. I mean, reminds me of prom songs and going out and having a good time. And you know, speaking of that, we have Dan Gutierrez.
What are the odds?
What are the odds that Dan would have called in right when I had that memory of, you know, wanting to get a limousine company and going out and having a good time with the friends?
Dan, how you doing?
Hi, sir. How you guys doing?
Doing great.
Pretty good, Dan. Great. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing good, man. Thanks for the opportunity.
No problem. You know, when the Rat Pack is always looking to going out and having a good time, you're the first person we call, don't you?
Yeah.
Dimensions by Dan.
I thought we were all about giving back now. Is it all about giving back or all about having a good time?
It all depends on what day.
We've been doing this for about a year and a half now.
Well, you know, you can do both. You can have a good time and give back.
And give back. That is correct.
Okay, now we're in business.
We've got it down to a science.
Yep.
But you know, Dan, let us know a little bit about obviously, you're with Dimensions by Dan. You're an excellent limousine service, and right now we have a lot of things going on. I mean, we have graduations, we have proms, we've got a lot of different things that are coming up, and it's important to stay safe. And most people don't realize is you have to find a good, reputable company that can drive you around, that you can stay safe with. We do it a lot as adults, and, you know, you have some great stuff out there. Talk a little bit about what you have out there, Dan.
Well, you know, the thing that most parents want is the safety of the children. You know, whenever they go out, they want to make sure that they don't drive. They're safe. We pick them up. We take them out to either go out and take some pictures, and then they go out to dinner, take them over to the prom. Then after the prom, sometimes some of them go to either High Hop or they go to Denny's, and then after that, they all get in the car, and we take them back home safely. And that's what they're looking for.
Absolutely.
Well, that's no joke because, you know, to get licensed to be a limo driver in Texas and in Houston, you know, you have to submit a physical exam, you have to submit a drug screen. You just don't get behind the wheel of a limousine.
Drug screen, you got to go to fingerprints.
Sure do.
There's several different criteria that you have to go through to receive your limousine license.
And you guys have all that covered. All your drivers, I'm sure, are totally covered by all that.
Well, we
You bet.
We've experienced a few of your drivers, and they've all been awesome.
I will say we use Dimensions by Dan here. They are the exclusive limousine sponsor for the Real Estate Rat Pack. And let me tell you, it's tremendous every time we do it.
Beautiful cars.
Beautiful cars. You've got those brand new limousines out there, and you have all types of limousines and buses, et cetera. But I'll tell you, it's absolutely tremendous in the way your drivers are, being able to get to a place safe. A lot of times we want to go out and have a good time. More importantly, we want to make sure that the guests that are with us are safe. So that's safety,
yes.
And have a great experience. So we use Dimensions by Dan, and I'll tell anybody who's out there, all the listeners, if you have a graduation, if you have a party, if you have a prom, if you want to keep your people, your family, your friends, your loved ones safe, definitely give Dimensions by Dan a call.
And one thing I always loved about his drivers, or love about his drivers, is that they're so patient. Because sometimes we're waiting on people. We're at an event. We're trying to gather everybody back together. And they never complained that they had to wait to get everybody together to go. They're there with a very service attitude, which
that's right.
I agree. And you know, and I promise we wouldn't throw him under the bus like that.
Yeah, we had the opposite yesterday with that bus.
Oh, absolutely.
So there was,
absolutely,
it's not a service attitude.
Yeah, yeah. And something else we did. Yeah,
all of our listeners. Yeah. This is your guy right here. You're going to put your children in a car and take them off somewhere. You want it with someone that you know and someone that has been recommended to you by us. This is your guy right here.
Dan, how can we get a hold of you?
Right, you can get all of me on there. You can look at the website of dimensionsbydan.com. You can call my office at 281-590-1101. And if you could just let your listeners know that anybody calls, please let me know that you heard it on the Rat Pack, and I will guarantee you 10% off.
Oh, that's awesome.
Well, that is awesome. So when you call Dimensions by Dan at 281-590-1101, mention the Real Estate Rat Pack and get a 10% discount.
Don't wait too long because it's booking up.
It's booking up fast. So get out there. Dimensions by Dan. Great individual. Dan, thanks a lot for calling us today, bud.
Appreciate you. Thank you very much.
Likewise. Thanks, thank nice. You. You know, up next, we still have, and we have somebody who's very important right now. We have the Randall Martin who is calling in right now. And Randall is out there on site in construction. And we probably have Bill Napick out there recording our show for us,
yes.
By the way. So, Randall, how you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great. How are you guys doing?
We're doing awesome. How's the build going?
Man, it's coming along wonderfully. You got a bunch of people out here sweating, putting in elbow grease, doing the hard work, and they're doing it out of the kindness of their heart.
So I'm thinking by the time we show up, all the hard work will be over, right?
You know what? We'll make sure to save something like putting together a swing just for you, Rob. I know y'all are expert swing putter togetherers.
So talk a little bit about YPN, the formerly known as NRG, is now YPN.
Yeah, the artist formerly known as NRG.
Yeah, the artist formerly known as NRG. Talk a little bit about that group and then how you choose these homes and what the rebuild program is.
It's so we choose to partner with Rebuilding Together Houston, which is an organization that homeowners can apply for. They can go on and submit their application, or someone can submit the application to them, and they go. Basically, Rebuild goes through and checks things out and determines the needs of the house, and then they pass the homes on to groups like ours to come in and take the reins from there. Rebuilding gives us the supplies. They're donated to us. We put in the labor.
So, and what are we doing in the house today?
Man, today we're scraping siding. We're replacing siding. We actually found a leaking pipe underneath the house that they're being fixed right now. We discovered some wood termites that are being treated. Painting the entire house and just really cleaning up the yard and making this a safe, livable place for this homeowner who otherwise would not be able to do this stuff herself.
And there's a swing set involved, Rob.
Oh, good. I can't wait to get there. Well, you know, I've been involved with several of the builds. It always feels really good I always look at the owners when they're seeing their house transition. It's a great feeling. Wouldn't you agree with that, Randall?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, one thing I said earlier to Bill was that, you know, these people, no one out here is doing this for their business. They're not doing it to gain anything. They're doing it because they want to be out here. They want to help. And people look forward to this all year long. Our 10-year-old, Cameron with a K, he's been talking about this bill for a long time. He's out here painting with Vanessa right now.
Well, if you can't, you know, you can't use child labor, you know, with your own family. No, but I've noticed you and Vanessa have always been very good about being out there, and I know you've had the kids out there before, so I think that's a great, and it teaches them, you know, to know about giving back to a community, and not only it's the right thing to do, but it also gives you that great warm fuzzies.
Absolutely. I mean, we're real estate agents. Realtors work communities. That's what we do. And you know what? We really should do more than just work and buying and selling. We really need to be giving back to these communities, because it's one thing to drive down the street and say, oh, I sold that house, or we helped someone buy that house. It's another thing to drive by and say, our crew helped rebuild a house in that area. Our crew helped fix the house for somebody. That's what really is what it really boils down to at the end of the day, when you look at it. How many people did you help?
Exactly. Give a little background on YPN. It's actually part of the National Association of Realtors.
Correct. And that is why we chose to rebrand the name. We were the executive committee of HR appointed a task force this year to sort of, you know, change is good. And NRG, the Next Gen Realtor Group, has existed for 5, 6, 7, 8 years more. And it's been under the same thing. Well, we have companies that have copied us, like NRG.
Yeah.
All that different stuff. But,
and you don't sell electricity, do you?
No, we don't. And we feel like there was sometimes some confusion. My big thing this year is, let's get rid of the confusion, let's get rid of the jargon, and let's go with what's consistently recognized. If we go to an event and you mentioned that you're with the Young Professionals Network, there's lawyer Young Professional Networks, doctor Young Professional Networks. It's just a more recognizable term. And that's what that was part of the inspiration of why we rebranded ourselves this year.
And I get to be the token old guy. It's always nice of them to let me come hang out with them. You know,
Rob, you're always a designated YPNer in our group.
I appreciate that very much.
Well, you know, Randall, we really appreciate it. The good thing is, for all of our listeners, they're actually recording a show courtesy of Bill Napick, which is one of our great partners today, which will be airing all about the build next week in this time slot. So we really appreciate that. Randall, thanks a lot for calling in today, bud.
Hey, absolutely, guys. Appreciate all y'all do for support as well.
And we'll see you in a little while.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Take it easy, Randall. You know, we have one more right now. We have one more caller coming in real fast. We have Jack. He's calling in. He wants to know about what kind of ventilation do you prefer on roofing. But, Jack, I'll let you ask that question. Jack, how you doing?
Pretty good. Hello, Victor. I have a question. We have an old roof, and we're going to get it changed pretty soon. And I just wanted to know what kind of products that I can save on energy and have proper ventilation for the attic.
Okay. Probably the best is your ridge vent. You know, the ridge vent covers the entire ridge area of a house, but if you don't have a lot of ridge, you have to have additional ventilation. You can have an air hawk. You can have even a solar air hawk, which is a great thing. But also, don't forget now, Jack, besides your ventilation, you have to have those soffit vents that are underneath your eaves. And the reason for that is because that draws the air in to help to push that hot air out of the attic.
And Jack, hopefully that answers the question. We are up against time. Yeah. We're going to have to let you go, buddy, but we appreciate the call in.
Yep. Ridge vent all the way.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Real fast, how can we reach you on Hudson Bay?
281-495-1997.
One more time?
281-495-1997.
You know, we've had a great show. It's been fast. A lot of call-ins. I always like to leave it with a good quote. Today's no different. Just remember one thing. God is with you. He will make everything right at the right place at the right time. Really good stuff out there, let me tell you. I want to thank all of our great guests that we've had on board, you know, not only with Hudson Bay Roofing, but Monica Vaca, everyone who called in, Randall, everybody else. We're having a great time today.
Don't forget Josh making it happen behind the board.
And Josh making it happen behind the board over here. Until next time, we are out.
Rat Pack is ready to answer your toughest questions. So tune in to the real...